act of remembrance has been filmed over the past few weeks, mostly before the second lockdown began, and all in a safe and socially distanced manner. We're determined that the current situation would not prevent us from commemorating remembrance, but we're equally determined to keep everyone in Wheathampstead as safe as possible and minimise the chance of a local outbreak of coronavirus. This year is particularly special, for Remembrance Day marks the centenary of the unveiling of our war memorial. The local history society have put together a fascinating display board which you can read by the bus stop in the high street. Now, whenever we can't come together physically, we can still be more than passive observers on this, our Remembrance Day. So the words of key parts of our act of remembrance will appear on screen, and where they are marked in bold, described as all, you might like to speak them out loud as your way of joining in. As usual, the centrepiece of our act of remembrance is the 2 minutes of silence when we shall honour the sacrifice of the ordinary men and women of Wheathampstead, who, often in extraordinary circumstances, gave their lives that we might live in freedom. Begin with some words from the Bible which remind us of the merciful and loving nature of God. This I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. So let us remember before God and commend to his sure keeping those who've died for their country in war, those whom we knew and whose memory we treasure, and all who lived and died in the service of humankind.
They shall not grow old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn.
At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. we will remember them.
Let us pray. Ever-living God, we remember those whom you have gathered from the storms of war into the peace of your presence. May that same peace calm our fears, bring justice to all peoples, and establish harmony among the nations. In your holy name we pray. Amen. The choir of St. Helen's Church are going to lead us in a hymn for remembrance. Of course, in the comfort of your own home or watching this online, you can join in by singing quietly or by singing enthusiastically, or perhaps you'll simply choose to listen in silence. O God, our help in ages past. Recording this has involved many people from around the community, and I'm really pleased that some children from St Helen's School are going to lead us in our prayers. After which, Father Michael Mannion from St Thomas More Roman Catholic Church will lead us in saying the Lord's Prayer.
Let us ask that God may give us peace. We pray for all the leaders of the different countries in the world, that you will guide them in the ways of freedom, justice and truth. May God give peace.
We pray for those who serve in the army, navy and air force in our country, that they may have wisdom, restraint, courage and compassion. May God give peace.
We pray for our enemies and anyone who wishes us harm, that you will give all of us kind hearts and gentle hands. May God give peace.
We pray for everyone wounded or made homeless by war, and for those held prisoner, and everyone who is sad because a loved one has died, that in all their difficulties they may know your love and support. May God give peace.
Look, the thumbs up.
We pray for everyone who works for peace and all who fight for justice. Help us to remember the cost of war and to work for a better tomorrow. May God give peace.
We commend to you all lives lost in terror and conflict, and ask that at the end of our lives you bring us into peace of your presence. Amen.
Let us pray together the prayer that Christ our Saviour has given to us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
In a moment, we will watch the representatives of different organisations laying the wreaths which they have laid earlier in the week. We lay these wreaths as a sign of our sadness at the death of those who've given their lives. But the poppy was chosen as a sign of hope, hope for a better, brighter and more peaceful future.
Thank you.
the men and women of the armed services in past generations gave their today for our tomorrow. So in this act of commitment, let us pledge ourselves to serve our community and our country, that we may help, encourage and comfort others and support everyone who works for the relief of those in need, and of course for the peace and the welfare of all. The act of commitment is followed by the national anthem.
Go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow we gave our today.
Let us commit ourselves to responsible living and faithful service. Will you strive for all that makes for peace?
We will.
Will you seek to heal the wounds of war?
We will.
Will you work for a just future for all humanity?
We will.
Dear God, we offer to you all the fears that tie us in knots, and we pray that you would replace them with love. Help us all to accept the hope you have placed in the hearts of all your children, so we can lead lives of justice, courage, and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen.
Amen.
As our act of remembrance draws to a close, we have honoured the dead, we have committed ourselves to serve the living, and now as we receive this final prayer of blessing, let's seek to build up the common good of our community. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth, and to all humankind, peace and concord, and to us and all his servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us for our online act of remembrance, remembering all the men and women through the years who've given their lives in sacrifice and service, but especially remembering the 105 men and one woman from Wheathampstead who died in the two world wars. If you like to, as a way of actively participating in remembrance this year, you might like to come and plant a small poppy in our giant poppy display. It's a Wheathampstead Remembers initiative located on the High Street near the War Memorial. Please do join in. Now, should you or anyone you know need support during lockdown, practical support, emotional support, please do contact the Wheathampstead Support for All group. Their details will appear on screen at the end of this service. God bless you. Do take care of yourself and of others.